I actually didn't play anything. You just heard AI-generated music.
Hello world, welcome to Serajology. In this episode, we're gonna train a neural network to compose music all by itself. Machine-generated music. The technical term for this is music language modeling, and it has a long history of research behind it. Markov models and restricted Boltzmann machines, which kind of sounds like something out of Half-Life or Bioshock. Hold on, babe. I've gotta go save the world using the restricted Boltzmann machine. Music is how we communicate our emotions and passions, and it's completely based on mathematical relationships. Octaves, chords, scales, keys, all of it is math. At the lowest level, music is a series of sound waves that create pockets of air pressure, and the pitch we hear depends on the frequency of changes in this air pressure. Sheet music is the annotation we've created to help us map these sounds into a repeatable set of instructions. So if machine learning is all about feeding data into models to find patterns and make predictions, could we use it to feed in music data to predict new songs? Absolutely. We're gonna build an app that learns how to compose British folk music by training on a British folk dataset. I was gonna go with American, but I didn't think it'd be age appropriate. There's too much sax and violins. Get it? We'll be using Tensorflow, the sickest machine learning library ever, to do this in just 10 lines of Python. We're gonna follow our tried and true 4-step machine learning methodology to do this. Collect the dataset, build a model, train the model, and test the model. To start off, we'll want to collect our dataset. So let's import the URL live module, which is going to let us download the file from the web. Once we import it, we can call the URL retrieve method to do just that. We'll set the parameters to a link in the dataset, and the name will call the downloaded file. We're using the Nottingham dataset for this demo, which is a collection of 1,000 British folk songs in MIDI format. MIDI format is perfect for us since it encodes all the note and time information exactly how it would be written in music annotation. It comes in a zip file. We'll want to unzip it as well. We can do this programmatically using the zip file module. We'll extract the data from the zip and place it in the data directory. Okay, so we've got our data. It's time to create the model. But before we do that, we need to think about how we want to represent our input data. There are two things happening. There's the main tune or melody, and then there are the supporting notes or harmony. Let's represent each as a vector. And to make things easier, we'll make two assumptions. The first is that the melody is monophonic. That means only one note is played at each time step. The second is that the harmony at each time step can be classified into a chord class. So that's two different vectors, one for melody and one for harmony. We'll then combine them into one big vector and use that as our input. We can just import our ML helper class and then call the create model method to do this. Music plays out over a period of time. It's a sequence of notes, so we need to use a sequence learning model. It has to accept a sequence of notes as an input and output a new sequence of notes. Plain old neural nets can't do this. They accept fixed size inputs like an image or a number. We'll need a special kind of neural network, a recurrent neural network. Those can deal with sequences since data doesn't just flow one way, it loops. This allows the network to have a kind of short-term memory, unlike Donald Trump. But wait, we want our network to not just remember the most recent music it's heard, but all the music it's heard. Like, a piece of music can have multiple themes in different parts of it, hopeful, sad, cheery. And if the network remembers only the most recent part, which was cheery, it's just gonna compose cheery stuff. We need a special type of recurrent neural network called a long, short-term memory network. This type of network can remember things from way back in the sequence of data, and it uses everything it remembers to generate new sequences. Our model will generate the sequences and chord mapping file to a file in the data folder. This is a serialized byte stream representation of our music that we can input directly into our model to train. By the way, every machine learning model has a set of what are called hyperparameters. These are the parameters that we humans set for how our model operates, like knobs on a control panel. How many layers do we want? How many iterations for training? How many neurons? You can just use an existing model with pre-tuned hyperparameters to build something awesome. So now we're ready to train our model. We can just call the train model method of our neural net class to do this. This will get the network to start collecting the input data piece by piece. It took me about 2 hours to train this on my 2013 MacBook Pro, but you don't have to wait until it's completely done training to test it out. Just wait until you see the best loss so far encountered saving model message. Once you see that, you can type in RNN sample into terminal with the config file flag and point it to the newly generated config file in your model's folder. That will generate a new song using the newly trained model you've just created. To generate music, we just sample the melody and harmony at each time step and plug it into our trained model. The model will then predict what the next notes will be. The collection of all the predicted notes is our newly generated song. There are some improvements that could be made for sure. The time signature is kind of sporadic, and in terms of long-term structure, there seems to be a lack of repeated themes and phrases. The solution may well be more data and more computing power. It usually is when it comes to machine learning with deep neural nets. Machine learning can help us learn the fundamental nature of how music works in ways that we haven't even thought about. Links with more info below, check them out, and please subscribe for more machine learning videos. For now, I've got to go fix a runtime error, so thanks for watching.